700 horsepower. Obviously, the gas in Japan is a little bit better, but let's go ahead and take a look at the engine.
Fully tuned. That's the only way I'd have it. Okay, let's run through a little bit of the specs here. Well, the first thing you're going to look at are the turbochargers. These are from Apex. They're RX6 turbos for you IHI nerds out there. That's the RX6 TCW76 with a P20 exhaust housing. That's in the middle range of the turbos, mated to upgraded airflow meters and Apex power intakes. When you're running a turbo this large, the boost tends to come on really late in the power band. Basically, that means that when you floor it, you're not going to feel anything to about 6,500 RPM, and you probably need to run the car to about 10,000 RPM to even, you know, take advantage of these turbos. Now, an engine, a normal RB26 engine, this is the Skyline engine, it can't handle that. This car, like I said, is 7 years old. It's gone through three engines, and one of the stories that they had was they revved it to 10,000 RPM when it was stock, and they blew out a brand new Nismo oil pump. So what they've done is they've upgraded the inside of the engine with an HKS Step 3 kit. Some of the other stuff that you always see in magazines and you read about, this is running a SARD 1000cc injectors. It's got a Tomei fuel rail. Obviously, you know, different kind of collector tanks. A lot of different effort went into making sure that the engine is durable. When you start going up into the 10,000 RPM range, things tend to break pretty quick. So moving right along, we have an HKS intercooler in front. What an intercooler does is, you know, engines are really simple things. I mean, humans haven't evolved that much and we can't change the laws of physics. So it's air and fuel. And everything in the car is designed to adjust the balance of air and fuel. So, you know, when you're saying, my car is running lean, that means you have too much air and too little fuel. So we'll add injectors, a fuel pump, you know, better gasoline, and then we'll raise the fuel back. And that's what a fuel computer does. So, and the turbochargers would be part of the air. You put huge turbos on, you're gonna suck in more air. Now, and this is sort of like, you know, physics 101, but air has molecules and, you know, little things floating around. And the colder the air, the more molecules you have. And that's why you're gonna want an intercooler. So it's sucking in hot air from here, and, you know, it's going, and then it goes through, and then through the intercooler, it gets cooled off because you're blasting.